Ravikant Bhat from IndiaNivesh is with us this morning to talk about those key expectations. Ravikant, what are you watching out for as far as key monitorables on an Axis Bank go?
No, I think the key monitorables for the last few quarters obviously have been the growth which is being driven by retail. We all know that the overseas loan book is being degrown. So from a headline perspective, the number tends to be typically lower compared to the retail growth which the bank reports. So I think this trend is likely to continue. On the asset quality side, we have seen the unwinding of BB and below, that is the sub-investment grade book. So that's a number to watch out for. The stress has been coming off and the performance has been improving. So that's one particular aspect that one would look out for. And obviously, I think apart from the growth metrics, I think what we have heard recently is the bank's plan to raise capital, which was not on the radar immediately. It was supposed to be taken up in the latter half, if not, you know, early next year. So that seems to have been advanced. There was no pressing need as far as the capital is concerned. So I think that's one item where we would like to hear clarification from the management as to what is driving this, you know, urgency.
On a blended basis, what's the loan growth or credit growth, the number that the street would be happy with?
So I think the retail loan growth has been somewhere around 18%, and the blended, the headline loan growth is a few percentage points lower. If you look at the systemic loan growth, it's been in the low teens, and Axis Bank typically has been slightly higher. So I think mid-teens or thereabouts, maybe slightly better. Because if you look at the ICICI Bank numbers, the domestic loan growth was very strong at 18% YOY. And with retail, you know, moving up more sharply at 22% YOY. So, you know, anything that, you know, breaks this trend above this would be a very strong number for Axis Bank.
Any concerns on slippages from the BB rated and below book?
So I think we have heard, you know, there have been certain accounts that have, you know, which have been a part of fresh stress, you know, accumulation during the quarter, a lot of accounts being discussed. So, you know, if these were already in the BB and below, then, you know, that's something which one would look out for fresh stress to emanate from. So, concerns, no, because this book had been, as I mentioned earlier, it had been, you know, shrinking for Axis Bank. But I would really, you know, look out for any sudden or outsized slippages in this quarter. Okay. I think we're estimating about 25 odd billion of slippages for Axis.
Okay. As far as recoveries and write-offs goes, I mean, it's still a slow process. Some of the NCLT cases are still not resolved. Anything in particular that you'd watch out for in this instance?
No, nothing in particular. So we all know, I mean, the delayed cases in NCLT. So, that particular item of path, except, you know, I would definitely be interested in retail slippages and, you know, what kind of recoveries are happening there. So, you know, Axis Bank typically, so there is some seasonality. So, if you look at the recoveries from return of assets, that tends to bump up once in a while. And Axis Bank has been particularly highlighting that given the stock of return of assets that they are carrying now, you know, there can be, you know, some fair chance of occasional strong recoveries from the stock of return of assets.
All right. On the credit cost front, I mean, we had very positive guidance coming in from an ICICI bank, but as far as credit cost for Axis goes, what's your expectation?
Okay, so I don't have the it should be better compared to your previous quarter.
What's your call on the stock currently?
Yes, having a reduced rating on the stock with a price target of 686, our argument was while a lot of new changes are being ushered in, that does not necessarily move the needle from a ROE perspective for 2021. So our estimates had stayed unchanged, and the bank's multiple was already at a historical median multiple. So we preferred to stay with the reduced target at with a reduced rating and a price target of 686.
Point taken, Ravikant. Thanks so much for joining in this morning. That's an Axis Bank for you. Reduced rating for them, but a good quarter that they are expecting nonetheless. Asset quality should see some improvement as well, and on an overall basis, good performance.